Welcome back on this Wildcat Wednesday, joined by Barbara Ames from the Wildcat Extension District. Barbara, thank you so much for joining us. We're here to talk about something very important and something that's preventable.
That's right.
You put together a class called Dining for Diabetes.
Dining with Diabetes.
Yeah. The focus of the class, it sounds easy on the surface, but what exactly does the class entail?
Well, in our class, we're going to be learning about meal planning, carbohydrate counting, just ways to manage diabetes. First of all, we start learning about what is diabetes and how it affects our body and how serious it is. But then we go into those other things, how to plan your meals and eat appropriately and get physical activity.
You know, one of the things that you were telling me about that I found absolutely amazing here is, you know, you'd say, like, why would I go to dining with diabetes? I don't have that. Well, Barbara points out that one in four people who have diabetes, they don't realize it?
They don't even realize it. Right?
Okay, so how do we go about identifying this and making sure that we're proactive?
Well, we want to have wellness checks, you know, check with your healthcare provider, particularly if you have diabetes in your family because you're at higher risk. You want to make sure that you just have a diabetes, you know, a blood mm-hmm. test when you go to the doctor.
So in other words, don't put your head in the sand on this.
Right.
You were telling me about some of the complications that diabetes can lead to. Because
right.
if you're of these one in four people that have it but are putting your head in the sand, what can this lead to?
Well, it can lead to things like blindness, kidney failure, amputations, heart disease, stroke. You know, it's a very serious disease.
And also, too, you were talking to me about medications costing a lot more.
Right. According to the CDC, people with diabetes spend at least twice as much on medications as other people, and their risk of death is 50% higher.
So I think the important thing when it comes to dining with diabetes is what you're telling me is, yeah, I might have a family history of it, but I can do something about it.
That's right.
What do you study in your class that can help me navigate through this?
Well, we learn about meal planning, carbohydrate counting. We learn what diabetes is and how it affects our body. We learn things like we need to check our feet every day and, you know, those kinds of things.
You've got to start from scratch at some point in time. When you tackle your first class, what is the foundation that you try to lay?
Well, we start out, like I said, teaching people what diabetes is and how it affects the body, and that way they can understand that they need to keep their blood sugar level because those spikes are what starts to damage the body.
How do you, throughout the course of the class then, that's where we start. Where do we finish?
Well, we just keep reinforcing those things. We learn how to plan meals appropriately. We learn that we need to eat regularly. We need to learn carbohydrate counting and you know, just those techniques.
I've got a dietary question for you.
Okay.
Let's
see if I can answer it.
What are some of the specific food items, or on the back when I look on the ingredients, I'm going to start with, what do I need to avoid?
Well, you need to avoid excess carbohydrates, and usually thinking of highly processed foods will have more carbohydrates and fat and the things that we don't need. So we want whole foods, we want lots of fruits and vegetables, but of course with diabetes we need to be careful about the starchy vegetables, and we do need to have a little bit less fruit because that's where a lot of carbohydrates are.
Oh, okay. See, and I would have associated that with healthy eating, but at the same point in time, I guess moderation?
Right. We learn a lot about portion control. We actually do cooking in this class. That's what sets it apart from some other classes. We do cooking, food preparation right in the class, mm-hmm. and they get to sample foods, learn how easy it is to make healthy foods, and that they can taste great. You mm-hmm. don't have to eat yucky food if you're a diabetic, but you can have some great food and still manage your diabetes.
So in other words, very hands-on.
Right.
From when you started this class to where you are now, what are some of the advancements that you've seen, not only medically associated with diabetes, but also nutrition-wise?
Well, people, they learn how to eat more healthfully, so they don't have those spikes in blood sugar. They're not going to the doctor as much. Another thing that's really important about the class is the connectedness and support that happens among the people.
Mm.
I've had a lady at one time that came in newly diagnosed, very overwhelmed and frustrated, as you would be. And after she'd been in a couple of classes, and some of the other people were able to talk to her and say, well, here's what I do, and, you know, it's not the end of the world, and she was feeling a whole lot better about it, and, you know, made that comment of how appreciative she was of the class and the other people in the class.
That may be the most important thing, then, the community bond.
Right.
Why don't you take us through the particulars? Where are we going? How do we sign up?
All right. We're going to be doing these classes this time in partnership with Labette Health. So they're going to be at the Rector Diabetes Center, west side of the Labette Health campus, mm-hmm. there in Parsons on Highway 59. They're going to be on Thursdays in August. So
okay.
The 1st, the 8th, 15th, and 22nd, four classes. And then we come back in December and we have what we call a reunion class, just to get connected again and see how people are doing.
Well, that's tremendous, the fact that you not only build that community support, but then you bring everybody back
right.
together.
Right, and we encourage people to stay in contact if they make a friend in class. You know, it's good to keep that friend.
You can give Barbara a call. You can sign up also, too. You guys have a wonderful Facebook page. It's so informational and a great website as well. Barbara, I want to thank you so much for joining us. Now, I'm going to put you on the spot.
Uh-oh.
You come back in December after a reunion and tell us how it went?
We can do that.
That's going to mean you want to be a part of this for healthy living. Barbara, thank you so much for your support for the community. We'll come back with more KOM Morning News right after this.